to us. Let's hear it.
Yeah, let's. Yeah, we want to hear your story.
Not aggressive.
Good. We're not aggressive either.
Okay, good. I was with a chick for 2 years.
Mm-hmm.
She got pregnant. Mm-hmm. I tried to convince her to keep it. Mm-hmm. I wanted it.
Good for you.
Trust me. I all about children and whatever.
Mm-hmm.
But it was her choice. She decided last minute to get rid of it. I had no choice. I sat in the lobby for hours mm-hmm. while she did it.
Mm-hmm.
Worst day of my life.
Mm-hmm.
Didn't like it.
Mm-hmm.
Didn't want it.
Mm-hmm.
But it's their choice.
Actually,
I don't understand the thing.
Okay.
And then you bring kids here. They don't know what they're.
Children know. Children know.
But it's Saturday. They should be playing, not doing this.
You know what? They are learning the truth about abortion. But you know, I'm going to go back to your abortion because before I was a Christian, I was one of those women too, more than once. Okay. So I can see that your heart. I can see that your heart hurts over that baby, because you know that was a baby. Those babies are not choices. They're just not choices. We have been lied to. Do you have one of your we've been lied to tracks with you? Okay, I've got one of those. But we have been lied to as American people. We all started out in the womb. We weren't choices. We were human beings developing in the womb, just a little bit smaller.
But there
and you know
are
what? You have
bigger problems in this world to fight about than this.
Oh no, we all have to have a heart to defend humanity. If we lose that, we've lost everything. And look where we are right now. Look at we've almost got
in a world of shit.
We've got anarchy in the streets right now, almost.
Yeah, there are bigger problems than abortion.
Okay, well no. On January 22nd, 1973, the Supreme Court overstepped, made a law, which it never should have. It's unconstitutional. There's not privacy in our Constitution. Never should have been decriminalized. Abortion was once illegal. They decriminalized it, and they also stripped away the rights of unborn children. In other words, when were you born, by the way?
88.
Okay, so you actually are a survivor. What year were you born?
89.
Okay, you're a survivor. So anybody after that
I wasn't a survivor. My parents were ready. My parents were.
Well, no. You're a survivor. Anybody born after 1973 is a survivor of the abortion Holocaust. But you know, you have a right to mourn for your child, and you are right. There is relevancy and truth in what you said. Men have no rights in this land. As far as if you want your child, you have no rights. You can actually be arrested in there trying to save your child.
Yeah, I'll tell you right now, worst day of my life.
Yeah, I can see that, and I'm so sorry that happened to you. And I can see that it really hurts you. And I had to repent of what I did. I mean, I was just this crazy, rebellious woman who only cared about myself, you know? So I don't even like to be called a victim in what I took part in. But that's why
you can't tell me that every female feels the same way. Everyone takes problems a different way. And you can't tell me that anyone that got raped and pregnant would feel the same or would want to keep that as a reminder of some terrible thing that happened. You can't tell me that that's okay.
Oh, it's horrible. It's horrible. But you know what?
To keep it and remind you of that.
Like, to take a crime on top of another crime.
Anyways. They're going to remember
anyways. And you know
anyways.
What? There's actually, I would encourage you, there's a woman named Rebecca Kiesling. Mm-hmm. She's got a website. There is a huge movement right now of people that were conceived in rape or incest that are alive today because their mothers made
and their family.
One of my dear friends, Diana, her mother was raped
but
at 12.
Not
at 12
everyone,
years old.
Not everyone takes it the same.
It's very painful, but we should never,
and
ever.
It's painful for a girl to already come here and do this. And you guys are yelling at them.
No,
we're
not
off air.
No.
Did
you? You didn't see how we talked to them, hon. You were walking by. You didn't. There was
right.
nobody even going
you're
in.
You're right. You're right.
You didn't see. I'm out here. I'm one of those women, and I don't want to see them go through what I went through for so many years. And I've ministered to so many women. I can't even begin to tell you. I had to go through post-abortion counseling. I can see you crying, and I'm so sorry that you went through what you did. Can we pray for you? Can we pray for you?
I don't believe in God. I don't.
Well, I didn't at one time either.
I went to church as a child. Mm-hmm, yes. I asked him. I was saved. I was mm-hmm. baptized. Mm-hmm. I grew my hair long. Mm-hmm. I grew my hair long. They asked me to cut my hair.
Yeah.
And then as a child, before I even ever was old enough to have a job, mm-hmm. my mom filled out a pamphlet. How much did she make on her paycheck? How much was she donating to the church?
Yeah, that's not of God. You know, that is not of God. That's not how God wants us to be. It's not. That's not the true Jesus. Jesus, he doesn't even want, you know, we shouldn't know what our right hand gives to, no, that's, and unfortunately, the westernized church does not represent the true Jesus.
That's true.
It just doesn't. We're a mess. The church in America is a mess. More concerned about how much money they make, more concerned about things than people. And, you know, as a Christian, I'm sorry that happened to you, but you know what, that's not the true Jesus, what you experienced. That isn't.
But they are the representation of Jesus.
But they're not, and it's hypocritical, and it's wrong.
Anybody can walk around and say, I'm a Christian.
Anybody can.
Right?
Then why doesn't the Christians as an organization take a stand and, I don't know, represent the true Jesus?
Well, actually,
you're right. And that's what we're doing.
Why don't you preach the true meaning of Jesus?
And there are people that do that. There are people that do that. You're right. There are people that are hypocrites that go to church every single week.
So why are these people multimillionaires paying no taxes? Why are they the face of Jesus Christ if you are actually the face of Jesus Christ?
Because people want an easy walk with Christ. They don't want to come out and try to reach out to women like we're trying to right now. It's easy to just go to church and you know, sing and go home and not
feel good.
It makes them feel good. But that's, you know, and when you say an organization, Christianity is not an organization. You become a follower of Christ. That's what being a Christian is. It's not going to church. It's not going to church. You become a follower of Christ. And my name's Michelle, by the way.
Justin, nice to meet you.
Justin. Deanna. Thank you so much for coming and talking to us. I mean, we really care.
You know, you humbled yourself.
Yeah, you know,
and
you really did.
But I still don't agree with this.
That's okay. And God is working on your heart.
Go for it.
You know, God is working on your heart. And I'm glad you came over to talk with us.
Yeah.
You know, that you didn't just keep on walking and have anger and bitterness.
Yeah.
Okay, because the truth is...
But I'm still angry and bitter. I live right behind you. This upsets me.
You know what it does? And it brings memories back, doesn't it?
It's someone else's choice.
Can I give you this?
Sure.
You know what? Let me see if I've got
some time to look over it. You know, God says in His Word that when we stand before Him on that day of judgment, you know, that we'll have to give an account for everything that we've done. And your girlfriend will have to give an account for what she did to your baby. Okay? Now, men, they do have a responsibility to protect women and children. And you said you tried. You know, you tried to defend your baby. You didn't want that to happen to your baby. You wanted to keep your baby. You know, and you saw what a blessing a child is. So a child is not a choice. It's a blessing. It's a gift from God. You know, if there was a man walking down the street and he decided to use his body to hurt me, that would be wrong, right? And you, I'm sure if you saw it, would try to stop him from doing that. That would be a wrong, bad choice, right? He can't use his body in whatever way he wants to hurt somebody else. And that's what happens when a woman has an abortion. She uses her body to hurt her child, okay? She pays someone to do something unnatural, to rip her baby out of her womb.
Do you know how many unnatural things happen in this world that, like, this is not the biggest problem?
Well, you're right. This is a symptom. This is not the main problem. The main problem is we've rejected God and His Word. Because God says, thou shalt not murder. And if we obeyed God, then we wouldn't have things like abortion, you know. And there's other areas in life that we're seeing the consequences of disobeying God.
The protesting is one thing. My biggest problem is having kids who don't understand. Who should be playing with each other in backyards.
Let me share something with you. The reason why many of us are here today, my friend, Sandra, her mother used to come out faithfully every week and bring her children. And now Sandra, her daughter, comes with her 6 children every week out here to minister to moms. Now she could go and spend the time at the beach or do all these fun things, okay? But the Bible says to speak up, you know, for those who have no voice. To be a voice for the voiceless, a defender of the weak.
here.
So it's good to do fun things, but it's also good to stand for righteousness and truth and to teach and instill in our children to do things like that.
Do you know who Jesus hung out with?
He hung out with his criminals. Disciples. He also hung out with sinners, yes.
And, if I walked into the church tomorrow, right now, the way I look, I would be asked to leave.
Well, if you went to the wrong church, right? And
any
that wouldn't
church,
be the true church.
Any church I go to right now.
You come to church with me Sunday and we'll see about that. Okay? You come to church with me and see if anybody asks you to leave. And they won't. They won't, because God, when he came to set sinners free. Okay? To take them as they are and transform them into something new. Okay? Yeah, we all have a beginning, a start. You know, I didn't used to, if you would have told me 10 years ago that I would be out here standing in front of an abortion mill and preaching about Jesus, I would have laughed in your face. Because I grew up in the church, but I was a hypocrite. I was the biggest hypocrite of them all.
Yes, you did.
I was fornicating with my boyfriend, and I came to an abortion clinic when I was 18 too, because I didn't want my pastor dad to find out that his little girl wasn't a perfect little angel.
So she can totally relate to what you're talking about.
So I was the biggest hypocrite of them all.
The church I went to, the pastor's son taught high school. You know what that kid did? Had sex with a high school student.
No doubt. It doesn't surprise me at all.
You know how much they try to hush that? Weird.
Yeah.
Where is God?
Well, see, God, he allows certain things
allows
to happen.
He allows us to make our own decisions because we should choose for ourselves. He gave that to us.
Think about it this way. Think about it this way, sir. If you have children, would you force them to love you? Or would it be more meaningful for them to love you because that's in their heart to...
That's not fair, because what child doesn't love their parent?
Why?
Okay, well, this is the thing, okay? Because parents are sinful, right? And some parents do things that are wicked and wrong, right?
You don't do anything that's wicked and wrong?
I do, and I have to repent when I do it.
Why?
That's the difference.
What happens when you repent?
And trust in God, I'm reconciled to my Father, and he forgives me.
So you get to sin and do wicked things and ask for forgiveness and all is good.
And that's a thing. When I have it's about where our heart is. Is my heart to go and to sin? No. When I sin, I'm grieved that I sin.
Why?
I don't want to sin.
Didn't it feel good?
Well, it's temporarily, there's temporary pleasure in sin. Otherwise, it wouldn't be like a tempting. Right? There is temporary pleasure in sin.
So then women abortions, we can all go back to Eve and how she ate from the fruit of the tree that she wasn't supposed to. So this is technically your fault. I could say this is your fault.
Well, ultimately,
if you want to go to the book.
But who gives... God gave responsibility to the man to be a spiritual guide for his family.
It's God's fault.
Sir, we are given the choice. We can choose to...
But if we're going to trace this all the way back to the root, it is God's fault.
God says in Deuteronomy, I've set before you life and death, blessing and cursing. Therefore, God says, choose life. His desire for us is to love him, to obey him, to keep his word, because he knows that then we will have blessing.
But if our life is furthered by somehow, you know, stopping something that happened, then we're still furthering life. So... if he gave us the choice to end life, to further our own life, whose fault is that?
That he gives us, it's just like this. I will tell my children, you know, I want you to cross the street and you're going to look both ways because I want to protect you. I don't want you to get hit by a car. Now, I'm going to always teach my children, look both ways, look both ways, look both ways before they cross the street, right? But if my child decides, I'm going to give my child that option because I'm going to let him go out and, you know, as he gets older, do things on his own, and he has the option, right? I can't take away his choice to look both ways. But if he values his life, he's going to look both ways before crossing the street, right? But I will always teach my children and instruct him because I love them to look both ways. Now, if he chooses not to look both ways and he gets hit by a car, it's his fault. There's a consequence for disobeying his mom.
So if you
value my life, and I've made it 27 years.
Well, you value your life enough to eat, you know, every day to maintain your life. You probably look both ways before you cross the street. And you probably work so that you can have money.
In 2 days, I've had a pack of ramen. I do work because I live in a house with other roommates.
Right.
And I have to.
But what I'm saying is you value your
life
to some extent.
That's not valuing anything.
You know, you may not value it to what you should, but you value your life to some extent. You realize that you do have value. You know, God has given you intrinsic value.
My value is someone else would be sad if I killed myself. Otherwise, I've done it years ago.
Well, you know, all of us, I think, have come to a point in our lives where we didn't want to live anymore. I've definitely come to that point.
I still don't want to live. No. I can't wait for the day a car hits me.
Well, if that were true, I'm sure you would have gone out and killed yourself, okay? But, listen, there is hope in Christ.
People stop me all the time.
You know, I understand that without Christ,
do you mind if
you feel hopeless?
A cigarette in front of you?
I don't mind. My mom smokes. So, you know, without Christ, there is no hope. There is no reason to live. There is no reason to get up in the morning. So I understand why you would feel that way.
What does your mom do?
She was a nurse. She's retired now. But, you know.
And your mom was a nurse and she smokes?
Yes. Oh, believe me, I work in a nursing home and a lot of the nurses smoke. But anyways,
because
my friend.
It's a stressful job.
But listen, because this is very important, okay? When you stand before the Lord one day, you're going to have some knowledge here. You're going to be without excuse because God has given you the truth, right? And you're willingly choosing to deny God, okay? And continuing to go your own way, okay? But He is being merciful to you and gracious to you. He shared the truth with you, okay, through us today, okay? That Jesus came to die for you, buddy, for you. Not just for me, all right? But for you. He died for you, and He desires that you would come to know Him intimately, to have relationship with Him.
I did, and church ruined it.
But we can't use that as an excuse. Just because there's wicked people in the world who call themselves Christians, who are hypocrites, we can't use that as an excuse to not love and serve God obediently ourselves. Does that make sense? You know,
but I was young and that was the church. They knew
and they were wrong. They were wrong. And you're right. You're right in everything you're saying there. That they were hypocrites. They didn't teach you right. They didn't walk you in the ways of the Lord. They didn't reach you His word. They didn't act like the church. They weren't true Christians. They weren't loving their neighbor as themselves. They were wrong. But that's not who Christ is. Read His word. See what Christ was all about.
I read His word. I did Awana. I had to read Bible chapters
so,
all the time.
So you know that what they were doing was contrary to the word of God. What they do when they act wickedly, that's not what Christ teaches.
But do you believe every single piece of the Bible?
I believe it's an inerrant word of God. Yes.
So you believe Moses parted a sea?
I do believe that.
How can no one do that today?
You know what? God, what the work that He did in my life, to me, is more miraculous than a sea being parted. You know, if you would have known the old me, I'm serious. If you would have known the old me, you
more
would...
More miraculous than seeing the sea parted.
Yes. What happened in my heart, the change that has occurred in my life, and it's from nothing that I've done. It's not because I decided to be a better person. It's because Christ came and indwelt in me, and now He took out my heart of stone. And He gave me a heart of flesh. And now I love the things that God loves. And I hate the things that God hates. This is one of the things that God hates. He does. It says He hates the hands that shed innocent blood.
So you don't like gay people either?
I love gay people enough to share with them the truth. That if they continue, even heterosexual...
But they're born that way. So what if someone was to do an abortion because they knew their child would be gay? Would that be okay?
Let me ask you this, okay?
No one chooses to be gay.
Are we born to fornicate? Are we? Are we born to lie?
Yes.
Are we born to steal? Yeah, we're born to sin, but it doesn't mean we should fulfill those desires, those fleshly desires. Just because we have a tendency to do something doesn't mean we should carry it out, okay? Like, a man may have a tendency where he wants to rape women when he sees them.
I don't have that.
Okay? I'm not saying you do. I'm just saying a man may have that tendency, but he should suppress that, wouldn't you agree? He should suppress that tendency. If that is something in his heart to do, he should not do it because it's a wrong tendency. It's a wrong desire.
That's not something that should dwell in the heart. Something that dwells in the heart like that is not of God, as you were.
You're right. It's not of God. But people do things all the time that aren't God.
God created that human that has these unnatural desires.
But He gave you the choice to do or not to do.
He had the choice to not be a monster, but he chose to be...
God's just playing one giant game of Sims.
A monster.
Yeah, He chose to do that. And every day people choose to do those things.
Why does God bring upon us these people that rape children and do monstrous things like that. Why would he bring those upon us if...
Because it's our choice, man.
It's our choice,
well,
I guess.
You guys, would it be better if God had given us no choice whatsoever and we were forced to obey him? That would be a dictator, right? Where we're forced to have no other option but to do as he says. That wouldn't be a loving God.
We're already forced to do things.
What do you mean? Like, give me an example.
Pay taxes, pay whatever else it is you pay.
Right,
I mean,
right.
You're supposed to abide by the law.
Yeah, of course, so there's not complete anarchy, right? And we agree that it's good to do certain things in our society, like not steal, not lie, not cheat on our taxes. You know, it's good not to do those things. It creates order, which God has created. He has created order.
There is no order today in our world.
Well, there is some order. Like, we have, you know, there's order in the earth, the way that it's, you know, rotating and keeping us up on this globe and pulling us to the ground so that, you know, we're not falling off the earth. You know, there is order. There is some more natural order to things. But you're right. There is chaos, too. And there's disaster. And there's all these other tragedies
that happen.
And there
are worse things than a girl aborting a child.
But, sir, this is wrong, too, wouldn't you say? And shouldn't we still...
But
yeah.
This is the least of anyone's worries.
Well, not according to the Lord, you know. He says it's an abomination to him. And if we truly love what he loves, then regardless of what we think the problem is, you know, we're just a dot on a map, you know. But God, he loves us. Why? We don't deserve it, that's for sure, right? All have sinned and fallen short of the glory of God, every single one of us. Right? We violated his commandment. We've all rebelled against him at some point in our lives. Okay? Even those of us now who come into agreement, we say, God, we understand we're wicked and we need you. You know, that's the difference. Okay? I'm not going to be proud and say, I don't need God.
Okay.
Of course, I need God to for my heart to be.
You have a child and you want to shelter them from certain images, you want to shelter them from certain things as they're a child. Why? Like, what is this gory image that you're... projecting on these children.
This is the truth. And a child...
Listen.
I had a child this morning.
So children shows in the morning should be about dudes raping chicks and how things are bad, and they should just show gory shows instead of...
No, I agree with you. We should protect our children. But we should not shelter them to the extent where they are oblivious to all evil in the world. Okay? There is evil in the world. That's the fact of the matter. Okay.
And she told me she wasn't yelling at chicks going into here, and she's yelling at someone going in there.
Well, we have to speak up so they can hear us.
Because you can't get close enough.
That's why I have this silly... Well, no, they say if we even step a little bit closer,
right,
then they'll arrest us.
Exactly.
So.
Because it's wrong.
Because
you have
to what?
You have to listen to... You have to abide, right? So that's...
We have to...
It's a dictatorship that you can't go in there and talk to these people, right?
You're right. And if we have laws that are established in accordance to God's law, that would be a good thing. Like, thou shalt not steal. Okay, we have laws for people not to steal things. Okay, and that's good. That's in accordance with God's word. Okay?
But that's not accordance to God's word. That's... general man law. If you steal something from me, I'm going to kill you. That's
well, there's a new covenant now, okay, that was introduced when Jesus came. Like he said, you've heard it said before, do not commit adultery, but I say to you, if you even look with lust, you've already committed adultery in your heart. Okay, so what did he do?
We're all guilty then.
There you go, my friend. And that's why we all need a savior. And we can choose to suppress that truth and say, well, I don't need, I'm my own God. You know, when we all know that's not true. I don't have to convince you guys that there's someone greater than us that created all of this. Okay? Because I don't have the ability to create a tree. So
isn't
somebody
the
smarter.
Earth beautiful enough to not call it God? These things occur, the rain falls, and the environment. Isn't that beautiful enough then to say that an alien somehow...
Do you really believe an alien? It was an alien.
Do you not believe in aliens?
You believe in aliens. You believe in aliens.
Guys, I believe in an intelligent designer.
That is an alien. That's an alien.
Or the God of the Bible.
But do you believe in aliens?
You know, and
just because the alien wrote a book doesn't mean it's not an alien.
Lower your voice. Do you believe in aliens?
I don't.
You don't believe in aliens?
I personally do not believe in aliens.
Why?
I believe that God...
Why do you not believe in aliens?
Because it doesn't talk about, in the Bible, anything about other life forms on other planets.
He's an alien.
However, okay, the point is that if it's true that God exists, okay, let's just say hypothetically, it's true that God exists and he's real and his word is true, then when I stand before him on the day of judgment, I'm going to be clear, all right? If I'm wrong and we just turn into butterflies when I die, then praise God. Nothing bad happens. But if you're wrong in what you believe and you die and there is a God and you have to stand before him on judgment day.
Wait, but you just said if you're wrong, then praise
then
God.
Then I turn
but if
into
you're
butterflies.
Wrong, then there's no praise
if
God.
If you're wrong, then you've lived your whole life, the only existence that you've only had in your entire life.
But I'm having the time of my life, my friend.
But if
this is
you
the time
are
of your
wrong,
life right now?
Yes.
Then you
protesting
have spent
abortion.
Your
I'm not
time
protesting.
Of life.
I'm here to proclaim to these women the truth of God's word. It's not a protest. I'm proclaiming it. That's what
how
God tells us to do.
How do you feel about Mayans and Aztecs having landing strips?
He says to go out and preach
that?
The gospel to all creation.
You don't believe in aliens a little bit at all.
Sir, please, this is so important. And I don't want you to get off on all these rabbit trails. Let's center and focus, okay, on the heart of the issue.
No, I'm listening to you.
All right? Because God, you know, he's so big. He's so big, okay?
How do you know?
Because it's... I know he created the universe, and I've seen how big the universe is.
So
I've watched these documentaries where it's like...
Why hasn't
on Discovery
like the,
Channel?
Why hasn't something like anything no. in the Bible happened today?
Don't lie. That's a sin.
Say that again.
Why hasn't anything that's been in the Bible happened today?
What do you mean?
Noah's Ark. Jesus coming back to life. Parting of the Red Sea. Talking to a burning bush. Turning water into wine. Feeding however many people with... A piece of bread and two fish.
A different age.
A
different age. You know, God showed himself, and still people don't believe. He showed himself. He did all these miracles, and still people don't believe.
She's yelling at people. They said they don't yell at people.
They have to speak up to go through, penetrate that glass.
I know, you have to tolerate the hangovers.
Hey, if you had to talk to somebody inside a building, would you not speak up?
But that's yelling.
She's not yelling.
That is yelling.
Okay, well, define it how you will.
My mother yelled at me, and that was yelling.
We have to speak up, and it is hard. It is hard. That's why I use this, so that my tone doesn't sound like I'm yelling. Okay, that's why I use these. It is hard to speak up for these babies. To these women without raising your voice, okay? But we're not angry. We love these women. We love their children. We want them to make right choices so they don't have to face the consequences of their sin, okay? Like Michelle, you know, she tried to attempt suicide many times after she took the life of her children because she had to live with the guilt of taking the life of her child. So she doesn't want these women to go through the same thing that she went through. She wants them to make right choices, learn from our experiences, right? So that's what we teach our kids too, you know? Learn from mom and dad's mistake, don't repeat them, you know?
My mom knew my dad for a week. She came back to Florida and surprise, she didn't abort me.
Praise the Lord, praise the Lord.
She had a sponge in her purse. I don't know if you know what a sponge is. She didn't use it because she was, a sponge was before my time, you stuck it up your hoo-ha and spermicidal, whatever. Couldn't get pregnant.
That was in our time.
Okay.
My mom met a man, partied, got drunk, forgot to use it. Here I am. She didn't bore me. I'm glad she didn't.